Hello everyone, this is Anson from AnsonAlex.com, and in this video I'm going to provide you with an overview tutorial on the standard typing technique to help you increase your typing speed and efficiency. If you are somebody who feels like they're not typing fast enough, or you're always looking at the keyboard when you're typing, then this is perfect for you. I will say that some people have developed their own typing techniques that work really well. If you can type fast and you don't have to look at the keyboard, then maybe you don't need to use the standard typing technique. But again, if you feel like you've hit a plateau in your typing speed and accuracy, this is the way to go. You can increase your speed. You'll have less errors when typing, so that means less hitting the backspace and having to retype things. And it will increase your overall computing efficiency because, primarily, you don't have to look at the keyboard. So you can be looking at something else while you're typing. You can kind of multitask in a sense, so you can get more things done in less time. So in order to start typing with the standard technique, we need to learn a few things. So let's talk about what the standard technique involves. In the standard typing technique, each key on the keyboard is associated with one of your fingers. So there's only one finger that's going to type the A key, only one finger that types the L key, and so forth. And you can see with the chart that I have up on the screen which finger is responsible for which key. It may be a good idea to print this chart out and put it next to your computer as you're starting to learn the standard typing technique so that you don't forget which finger is responsible for each key. This chart, along with all the links that I'm going to mention in this video, are available on AnsonAlex.com. There's a link to that article in the description of this video here on YouTube, so that will have all the resources that I mentioned here in this video. So if you look at the picture that I have up on the screen, we have all the finger responsibilities at the top, but then at the bottom we have what are called the home row keys. And this is really your baseline place to go when you start typing with the standard technique. These are the keys that your eight fingers should always be resting on when they're not being used. Obviously your thumbs aren't fingers, so your thumbs kind of hang around that space bar. You can see in the chart there that your thumbs are really only responsible for pressing the space bar. But your other fingers have a lot of responsibilities, and in order to make them work efficiently, we need to have a place for them to go when they're not being used that's a central location. So as you can see, the home row keys are A, S, D, and F for your left hand, and J, K, L, and semicolon for your right hand. Again, this is where your fingers should be when they're not typing. And it's extremely important when you first start typing to not cheat, per se, because it could be easy if you're typing a word like, let's say, nut, both the first two letters are with your pointer finger, and you would probably be able to go directly from N to U. And that's fine once you are comfortable typing and you've built in some muscle memory. But that can be detrimental to your progress in learning how to type correctly if you start cheating from the beginning, because typing is a multifaceted skill. One part of it is just knowing where the keys are and remembering where the keys are. But beyond that, it's also takes some physical ability. Your fingers aren't going to be used to all the positions that they need to go into when you first start typing. So by making sure that you're always going back to that home row, you're kind of working out your fingers per se, so they get used to where they're always going back to. They get used to making the proper movement for each letter on the keyboard. So it's really important to always go back to that home row. Now, if you're just looking to learn how to type efficiently on your own, there are some things that you can do to make sure that you improve your skills without kind of just stagnating a little bit, because it takes some responsibility. So first of all, try to type correctly in your day-to-day activities as much as possible. I know it might not be easy, it might be a little frustrating at first, and for a lot of you, you might actually type slower at first than you did with your own technique because you're not used to it. And your own technique you probably have been doing for years, and you've got pretty efficient with that technique. But what happens with the techniques that people kind of create on their own is they have a plateau. You're not using your fingers as efficiently as possible, so there comes a point where you just can't increase your typing speed with the method that you're using. So the standard technique that I'm teaching you in this video is a technique that has a much higher plateau. So once you really become an advanced typer, your speed is definitely going to be faster than most people who are using a customized typing technique that aren't using their fingers as efficiently. Remember, again, always go back to the home row when you're practicing. If you want to break it up a little bit, you can try some typing games. So there's a website, freetypinggame.net. I'll post a link again in the AnsonAlex.com article that I'm going to link in the description of this video here on YouTube. But that's a good way to just break up how you're practicing your typing. You can play games like Space Invaders and stuff like that, just so you can have a little fun while you're learning how to type. It's not always the funnest thing to do. And then, of course, a few years ago, I published a course on LinkedIn Learning, which at the time was lynda.com, and that is a multifaceted course. It covers specific tips and techniques for how each finger should be used when typing on the keyboard, and it also comes with a practice module that allows you to test your typing speed and accuracy, both for specific modules within the course and then cumulatively at the end of the course and at the end of each section. So if you're looking for the crash course to learn real quick, then that's probably the best way to go. But again, you can learn this on your own. You just have to be diligent and you have to hold yourself responsible for always typing the correct way, going back to the home row, even when it feels unnatural and even when it feels like your typing speed is hurt by that. So I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. If you want to see more technology tips and tutorials, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. That's all I have for you for today. This is Anson from AnsonAlex.com.